I was talking to my friend the other day about Jesus, Christ. And I don't remember why, but I happened to mention that Jesus was Jewish. And my friend said, he was? And I said, yeah, Jesus was Jewish. And he said, I don't think so. And I said, that's okay, it already all happened, doesn't matter what you think. But he argued with me. He was like, dude, Jesus couldn't be Jewish, think about it. I'm like, you fucking think about it, you idiot. What was he then in your, was he Presbyterian? What was he? Catholic? Okay, Jesus was Catholic. And he had a gold chain with a cross. And when they nailed him up, he was like, oh, that's why we have those. That finally makes sense. I didn't even know. Oh, fuck, that's me. I'm the little guy on it. Every religion has a strange story or a rule that doesn't make sense to me. You know, like every time there's a terrorist act, they always tell you on the news about how they believe they're all going to heaven, and every guy who does a jihad thing, and he gets 72 virgins. That's right. That's the story always. 72 virgins. Which, first of all, who are those women? Who are the 72 virgins? Does God have to kill 72 nice girls? And, all right, ladies. The good news is you're going to heaven. The weird news. Or does God just make them fresh like farm-raised salmon? He just whips up 72 women. All right, nobody fuck these. I'm saving them for that guy. It's a weird concept. You get your own 72 virgins for all eternity. First of all, they're only virgins when you first get them. Once you start fucking him, it's over. After a week, he's like, I only have 3 left. And 69 whores. That has to be one of the more confusing moments in God's life, when he's handing off 72 virgins to some guy who just blew up a bus in Tel Aviv. And he's like, all right, what the fuck am I doing? I don't even know anymore. I need a drink.